Okay, let's begin with the closure. I'm really happy to finish this also. To having all of you here, and that you I hope you have enjoyed as much as we have enjoyed the conference, and especially for those people that are coming from outside, it's an honor to have first this conference this year. And now it's the end, so the end for this edition, but the beginning of the preparation of next year. And I'm going to be really brief. I would like to just to thank my team because these moments have been hard, and I hope that all people could have so good people with you as me. Especially Francisco, who is there. After this stupid moment, we are going to continue with the closure, and we would like to also give you the awards for the different categories, and later I give the floor to the next person in charge of the conference, again Francisco, because it will go again to Salamanca. Do you want to say something?
Thank you, Miguel. This is not the closing session, this is a survival session. We have the survivor here, and also it's important that Miguel survives to the conference. He always has emotions in these special moments. It's a tradition as well. We can remember the first award he received 2012. Antonio Vaquero Awards in the conference. And, I want to thank to the hosting group, because I think this is, they allow us to feel we are at home, and it's marvelous having the same experience and the same spirit of the team conference also in other cities, in other universities, and we feel very well, very comfortable with, as I said in the opening session, we have new faces in this conference, and we hope that these new faces will be with us in Salamanca, because surprise, the next edition will be in Salamanca again. It's a 2020 year, then it's our 8th edition, and we hope we stay all together with you in Salamanca. Then thank you again, thank you again, Amino, Vicente, Francisco, and all the robotics team.
Well, thank you all for attending this this conference. I would like to thank especially Universidad de Salamanca, well, mainly the IA Group and Francisco, because they are the real root of this conference. And in our part, I would like to especially thank Miguel Ángel, who has done a huge effort to have you all here, and for these 3 days he has been really the father of the conference, and we have the mother up there, who has been Serrano, Francisco Serrano. Both of them have carried out the most part of the work, and that is a very big part. It has been a great success for us to have you all here. Everything has been okay. We have had no complaints, so that's very important for us. We're very happy about it. We have enjoyed you. This is a growing community around this conference. that every year goes bigger and bigger, and it's richer and richer, and we hope to see you all again next year in Salamanca and following years. Thank you very much.
Okay, and before we end the act, I would like to give you the awards. It's not the Mangel Awards, as David organized yesterday night, but these are the awards related with the best papers of each of the tracks. Okay, so to begin with this, the best paper in the category of computational thinking and robotics in education is to Bringing Computational Thinking to Hospital Classrooms, authored by Karina González González, Lorena Cáceres García, and Verónica Violán Juez. We are not here, so I'm going to go to the following one. The next award is in the category of Engineering Education Addressing Professional Challenges. It is for the paper Didactical Use of a Remote Lab, a Qualitative Reflection of a Teacher, authored by Natasia Lindman, Clara Villegas, and Francisco José García Peñal. Guidelines and data treatment, offered by Adriana Gamazo, Fernando Martínez Cabal, Susana Montoya Lange, and María José Rodríguez Conde. And the next award in the category of Bridging the Diversity Gap in STEAM is for the paper Increasing Gender Diversity in STEAM, a tool raising awareness for the engineering profession, authored by Maria Julia Balatore, Linda Barman, Jelle Borger, and other authors. It's very quick, especially when the authors are not here. The next category is Learning Analytics, the end of the beginning. And the paper awarded is Evolution of Decision Tree Classifiers in Open-End Educational Data Mining, offered by Tapani, Toivonen, and Inka Jormanainen. The next one is for the category Merging New Technologies with Health Science Education and Practice. The title of the paper is Proposal and Definition of a Methodology for Remote Detection and Prevention, authored by Manuel Casal de Sande, José Benito Bouza, and Alberto Comesaña and Jorge Peiro. The next award is in the category of Implementation of Qualitative and Mixed Method Researches. The paper awarded is Mixed Methods, Lesson Learned from 5 Classes of Doctoral Thesis, offered by Jaime Ricardo Valenzuela González. For Sustainable Development, offered by Irais Montserrat Santillán Rosas and Yolanda. Here? No? The next one is in the category of teacher education for ICT integration in classroom. The paper is entitled Adaptive Learning Based on AI with Predictive Algorithms, authored by Elvira García Rincón, Elvira Rincón Flores, Juan Comena, Eunice López Camacho, and Omar Olmo. The next one is in the category of Supercomputing Education Thinking in Parallel. The awarded paper was Facilitating the Learning Process in Parallel Computing by Using Instant Messaging, authored by Lidia Sánchez González, Rafael Manuel de Rivera, and others. The next one is in the category of smart learning, and the paper awarded is a new methodology for early warning of critical academic performance based on discrete predictive models, offered by Mandela Beca, Julia Moya Campello, and Alex Rabas. The next category is Educational Innovation, and the paper award is Visual Technologies for Local Design Competencies in Architectural Education, offered by Monica Vanessa Sanchez Ocula, Julia Martí Oli, and David Fonseca. Uncertainty in digital humanities goes to the paper Qualifying and Quantifying Uncertainty in Digital Humanities, a Fuzzy Logic Approach, offered by Patricia Martín Rodilla, Martín Pereira Fariña, and César Rosales Pérez. The next one for the 10th National Awards of Software Engineering for E-Learning goes to the paper Capturing High-Level Requirements of Information Dashboard Components through Meta-Modeling, offered by Andrea Vázquez in Helmut, Francisco José Arturo. In a doctoral consortium, the first one is for the first-year students, the rookies, and is analysis of the relationship between computational thinking and mathematical abstraction in primary education, offered by Hasna Chavi, Amina Ahmadi, and Juan Manuel Doguer. Next year at Kim. Okay.
Ahora foto distraída, todo mirando.